barbecue sauce. It's smooth. Then it gets a little spicy. So, you know, I feel like that's how I play. I'm smooth, but then when we score in the end zone, you know, it's always a party.
Those are social media posts from college athletes that are now using their own images and platforms to secure major endorsement deals. Now, it used to be against the rules, but not anymore. For years, the NCAA was able to use the name, images, and likenesses, or NILs, of student athletes for their own benefit. Schools were making tons of money, but the student athletes could not cash in. But now, thank God, things have changed. Last summer, thanks to a recent Supreme Court ruling, the NCAA implemented the NIL rule, which allows college athletes to get their piece of the pie. To discuss this further, we're going to bring in an NIL expert, Luke Fedlam. He is a non-agent sports attorney who counsels students, professionals, and retired athletes on NIL. Luke, thanks for being with us. This is all very exciting, but just like with anything else with these types of financial stakes, we want to talk about the benefits, but also maybe some pitfalls, maybe some challenges that people need to be aware of. So what are the benefits and pitfalls of NIL?
Well, Eboni, thank you so much for having me. And really, the benefits of name, image, and likeness are kind of what you talked about, which is for years, for decades, student athletes have not been able to earn compensation off of their own name, their own image, their own likeness. So name, image, and likeness, so that people understand, is it's the opportunity for a student athlete to contract or form a contract with a third party for the licensing or the lending for compensation of their name, their image, their likeness. So it's not even that schools are paying these student athletes. It's the student athletes just being able to go out and do deals with other companies. So one of the benefits is just being able to earn compensation in ways that student athletes have never been able to earn before.
Now, you know, when you are getting this kind of revenue, which could be anywhere from $1,000 to we've seen six-figure deals for some of these student athletes, that money's coming in and there is issues of taxes and payouts and all of this. So talk a little bit about what the student athletes need to know, Luke, in reference to, do they need an LLC? Do they need a tax accountant? What's kind of the management strategy?
The one thing to understand is that you are now in the business of sports when you engage in name, image, and likeness. So the education that needs to come with that is understanding what is the right structure for me. If it is that having a limited liability company, an LLC, to serve as kind of my protector, to limit my liability, to potentially help from a financial perspective in some respects, maybe that works for certain student athletes. Others, you want to think about if it's going to be a significant deal, hiring a lawyer to help you understand what it is that you're signing. Because we're seeing some of these deals. I'm seeing some of these deals where student athletes are giving up rights in perpetuity because they don't understand what that means. So helping them to understand a contract, potentially an accountant. We have the opportunity and fortune of working with a number of NFL teams. And this summer during the offseason, talking to teams, every single team that we talked to, of about seven or eight different teams, had a rookie who did name, image, and likeness last year for the first time that came up and said, hey, I did NIL. I didn't pay taxes on that. What do I need to do now? So the tax education, the financial education, the contract education, it's all critical.
Very important. Let's talk about HBCU athletes in particular. Obviously, this issue is getting better in terms of HBCUs. We all love the impact of Coach Prime and some other coach Morton over at the NCCU that are raising the visibility of HBCU athletes. But we know historically they don't get the attention of some of these, you know, D1 bigger, predominantly white schools. How does NIL benefit the HBCU athlete?
This is the best part about name, image, and likeness. It really is an equal opportunity, regardless of the school or institution that an athlete goes to, regardless of their gender, and regardless of their sport, that they have the opportunity to engage with that third party, that company, that brand. So the benefit to student athletes that are at HBCUs, and I've spoken with a few different HBCU programs, the opportunity that they have is to leverage their creativity, leverage their abilities. So one of the things that's important to remember is name, image, and likeness at PWIs predominantly is discussed around this idea of my athletic ability. But when we look at it, there are a lot of student athletes earning compensation simply because they have a large social media following. Maybe they're not an elite athlete, but they're able to have a following where they can promote a brand or a service. So helping student athletes at HBCUs in particular understand how NIL works. How can you navigate this? How do you get started? You could go back in your hometown and do a camp or a clinic for your particular sport and earn compensation. I always believe that we as a Black people are a creative people who have opportunities to engage in this space in ways that maybe some of our other counterparts can't. So I hope that student athletes at HBCUs don't look at this as just simply being, oh, well, this is for those big athletic department program schools. But no, name, image, and likeness is for everyone.
So we're talking a lot about college athletes. Let's talk a bit about high school athletes, because there's also opportunity for them. We see the Pennsylvania Interscholastic Athletic Association recently ruling that their students there can make money in high school. Do you think that's a good thing, Luke? Is that kind of a little more risky? What's your take?
So there are now 26 states across the country that allow their public high school athletic associations, allow high school students to earn compensation from NIL. Is it risky? Yes. But is there opportunity? Absolutely. And not just the financial opportunity for student athletes to earn compensation. In my opinion, it's the opportunity to educate young people on the life skills, the professional development skills that matter, to help them think through, to use whenever we, and I'm not a teacher at the high school level, but I know, having two kids, how hard it can be to keep the attention of young people. So when we can now use money to say, hey, you could actually go out and earn compensation now. So let's talk about budgeting. Let's talk about finance and taxes and understanding financial literacy and what is a checking account and a savings account and how does that work? If we can now impact young people through education because of their belief of the opportunity for name, image, and likeness, what a great way for us to make a more educated, younger generation.
Absolutely. And when we talk about generational wealth building in Black America, which we're talking about all the time nowadays, this is exactly what it can look like. Luke, thank you so very much for being with us and breaking a lot of this down for us. We appreciate it.
Eboni, thanks for having me.
Now, after the break, I'll speak with a student athlete who's taking full advantage of this opportunity, and he is getting the bag. They call him the king of NIL, and he's next on the Grio.